name. We are going to pray. Come on, bring your life in.
Did he just say it's time?
Yes, it's time.
We didn't have a lot of fun in the desert. We didn't have a lot of fun.
It's time to pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for your grace and your mercy. Father, we thank you for this day. Father, we thank you for even the press to get into your presence and to receive of you on today. Father, we treasure all that you are giving us on today. And we ask, Father, that you will continue to lead and guide us into all truth. Father, as we submit ourselves to you, we ask that you just have your way in this place. We thank you for focus. Father, we thank you for your presence reigning in this place. And Father, we thank you that every contrary spirit, that it's not like every contrary spirit must leave this place in the name of Yeshua. We thank you for your will being done on today, Father. We love you, we praise you. In the name of Yeshua, we pray. Amen. Amen. Come on, give your Father a hand clap of praise. Yes. And welcome to another episode of Covenant Vows in Contact. Come on and give your Father a hand clap of praise as we get ready for
it.
Okay. He said,
about that.
Think about it and get back to us when before class is over. If you get answers.
Good job. All right, come on. Come on, give a hand.
Yes, and Commissioner Mira is our next batter up. Okay, Article 7. We are made sons and daughters by the death, burial, and resurrection of Yeshua. Yeshua is the only begotten Son of Yahweh. Let me start over. We are made sons and daughters by the death, burial, and resurrection of Yeshua. Yeshua is the Messiah, the only begotten Son of Yahweh. This place is built upon that rock, and therefore the gates of hell shall not prevail. Matthew 16:13-19.
So be it.
And I wrote, we have the victory. We are saved by the blood of Yeshua through what he has done. And hell shall not, can't hold us captive anymore as long as we are under God's protection.
What does the only begotten Son of Yahweh mean?
The only one, to me it means the only one that he chose to come down to earth in the form of a man, a holy man, to die for our sins. The only one that he chose to do that certain thing that only he could do.
Well, all that's true, but that ain't the only begotten me. Only begotten. Go ahead, I'll give an answer later.
Come on, give y'all a hand for Commissioner Amira. And we're going to get more info on what it means to be only begotten, Brother Jonathan. Yes.
Yes.
Okay, today is our day of sharing. Amen. The second one for the year. Yes. Let me know when you're ready, Pastor.
1, 2. All right.
All right. Here we go with
that. It's just very, not too complicated, but only thing only begotten, the simplest way is he. There are many sons of God. You got the angels in the Old Testament, they were called the sons of God. And basically any kind of minister that was sent by Yahweh was called the sons of God. The men on earth, they'll be like, the offspring would be the sons of the prophets. You had stuff like that. Son basically means offspring. And right now we are sons and daughters of Yahweh. And when we come back, we'll be sons of God. We always be his children. But there, according to Yeshua, there are no females in heaven, so it'll be neither male nor female. So the reason why I bring it up, because it's very important, you know what only begotten means. The only begotten means the only one, when he said only begotten Son, the only one that's made up of the DNA or exactly like Yahweh. When you look at Yeshua, you're actually seeing Yahweh. You know, if I could just see him, you know, well, if Yah would put on flesh, he would just like Yeshua.
Yes.
the way the physical attributes would be the same. Yeshua, character, everything he did was like the Father. So that's why he said, I'm the only begotten. That's why he's basically God.
Yes.
He is God. He said, I am my Father, I one.
Yes.
Because he would be like the same DNA. It was like in one episode of the comic book, we'll find later that Iron Man had cloned Thor. He had took Thor's DNA and he made a clone out of him. Now that's a shrewd representation, but the DNA Thor went crazy or nuts or something.
Uh-huh.
But, and he gave that head hammer and everything like Thor. So he could pick up Thor's hammer if he wanted to. Because he was exactly like Thor.
Uh-huh.
Everything he did except his thoughts wasn't Thor thoughts.
Uh-huh.
And that was the only difference. You know, just in Yeshua, his thoughts, he said, not my will, but your will be done.
Yes.
So he did everything y'all said, but that don't mean that he always thought that way.
There you go.
So they had different wills. And it's very important that you know that, because when people say Yeshua is God, and this is why we pray to the Father, because Yeshua lets you know I proceeded forth and came out of my Father. So I'm not the Father, but I am my Father. I want. That's what he's saying. And that would be like Thor's DNA. Would look at him and say, that's Thor. I'm not Thor.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just an offspring.
Wow.
So.
That's good. That's good. Come on, give y'all a hand for that.
That's good stuff, people. Amen. Well, you gonna have to do attention to the camera. Yes. All right. Amen. So, I hope everybody caught that explanation. There's a lot of things that are being thrown around that are distracting, but I hope everyone caught that explanation and grab a hold to what the Father's saying.
Let me get a lot of feedback on this
mic. I don't hear no feedback no more. Go ahead. Say something.
Okay. That's Ellen Ryder. Yes.
It's just the emptiness in here. Go ahead.
Oh, okay.
That's why I can't move here.
All right, then. Well, now, today is our day of sharing. I'm very excited about today's sharing. Evelyn Nell won all the prizes. Yes. She sent the most things in there. And then, everybody, please let me know if you do not have the PowerPoint. Let me know. If you do not have it, let me know. And I will count to five. One, two, three, four, five. So that means that everybody has it. And we're going to start off fun. Yes. With this day of sharing.
Yep.
Woo! Yes. And it says, Rain and Truth Ministries, Watchful Warriors present The Shocking Evidence Continued. Coming in vows and
contrast.
Today's date is the 2/24, I almost said December, 2013. And our first slide is from our own Elder Lanelle. Chime in, Elder.
I'm having trouble with my phone. Let me know if there's issues on your end. But am I looking at the wrong thing? That first thing is not from me.
Yeah.
At least not the first thing on my slide.
The Chinese thing?
Okay. Oh, you want me to talk about it?
Yes. Any comments on it? What made you pick that and share it?
Okay. it's just so long ago since I said this. And my memory is not that good. But yeah, that came across on Facebook, and I just noticed all the different references had to do with the different things that we are to stay away from, and it was so many of them. I guess a little quick there, Chinese Lunar New Year celebration. And in that, it was saying that it's also called the Spring Festival, which we talked a lot about different festivals, especially
yes.
The Spring Festival. And it marked the start of the Year of the Snake, which we talked about that too a while ago. And then I noticed it said, according to the Chinese Zodiac, there was just so much things that was in line with all the teachings that we learn here in CVC. So.
Excellent. Come on, give her a hand.
Give y'all a hand for that. That's good. I thought that was a fantastic find and so significant with the times that we're in and with some of the things that the Father allowed me to see and share. Okay, next one. Click. Oh, this is for me. And I thought this was so appropriate because it says, this is from the sun, and it says it's a huge filament of super hot plasma, nicknamed the dragon's tail. Look at the how the plasma is coming up, and then you just talked about what is the scripture? The serpent that will drag it. We're going to have this, it's in here later.
It's Revelation.
Yes, in Revelation. I got it later. But isn't that something?
Mm-hmm.
I thought that was not
I can't see it. I can't.
Huh? Can you see it? Mm-hmm. Brother Jonathan, are you working the camera?
It looks like a
palette. Yeah, you can't see it. Go ahead.
Okay. Mm-hmm. It looks like a phallic, you said, up a little down?
From this point of view, yep.
See? Yep. You wait till you see some other images. Yes. Okay, what's our next one up? I thought it was too interesting. I mean, because we got so much going on in the spirit realm. And all these things that are being manifested naturally. This is another thing of the sun. Can somebody read the caption that's underneath it?
I think Anna should read it.
Anna, she's pointing her finger. She's trying to read it. Yes. She holding up 10 fingers. Very good.
I read
it. Okay. Brother Jonathan had his mic.
I'll go, Jonathan.
Okay. 1.5 million degrees solar atmosphere credit. NASA, the Atmosphere Imaging Assembly on the Solar Dynamics Observatory captured images of the sun's corona. This image shows the 1.5 million degrees solar atmosphere and is taken at the start of HIC sounding rocket observations released in January 23rd, 2013.
All right, thank you, thank you, thank you. You know this? I just want really look at these pictures because I'm telling you, to me, I've been seeing stuff. Any comments on that? Next.
So
yes, go ahead.
What are we looking for in this?
Well, this one I just want you to see the freakiness of it all. And the images how it looks like I don't know, they look like pictures from me or something. I don't know. I have a wild imagination. But, you know, it looks like different things happening. To me, when I saw these pictures, let me tell you what I thought. Stuff going on in the spirit realm when I saw these pictures. That's my thinking. But I just wanted to share them. Not necessarily so, but I just thought. That's what I thought.
I was thinking.
Was that tied to something that we talked about in CVC?
Well, it's something that we talked about in, I think it was whatever, knowing the times and the season that we're living in, and how we're living in the last days, and it might even be some messages too about how there's so much going in the spirit realm. There are a lot of dark spirits that have been released. The scripture by the enemy, the devil, and his angels being cast down to the earth. I'm not confusing anybody, am I? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Any other questions, anybody? Did I answer your question, Elder Nell?
I guess.
Well, get dorky. Brother Jonathan, what do you have a question?
These are recent images.
Yeah, these are, I think the date of this one might be on there as well. Okay. All righty. Next slide, please. Okay, this is you. You're up, Elder Linnell.
Okay, am I supposed to read it?
Yes, please. And then share.
My birthday, I went to the movie theater and I saw Les Mis, and his eye kept popping up. I seen the previous version with Liam Neeson and it was not there. So these new movie makers have added this subliminal message for us. And next slide.
Pan back a little bit, Jonathan.
Eyes everywhere.
Basically, it's just one eye in the background, and it is very prevalent. I kept closing my eyes at the beginning of the TV and praying, whatever they were trying to put in my head to get away.
Yes.
Yes, indeed. Now, it's eyes everywhere, isn't it?
Yep.
I saw that, and I was like, ooh.
Well,
just so you know, that's the same eye. It's just at different angles and different times in
the
movie. And
you
kept going back to that area for different.
The eye itself had nothing to do with the movie, at least it
had
anything to do with the plot. But it kept bringing you back to that same eye.
You know, coincidence? I think not. Seriously. And you really see it too, cause you could tell us in different scenes, but then it's like, why is that eyeball looking at me? Why is that eye still there? You know, it's very sneaky. That's the best word I can say. It's a sneaky attack. Sneaky. Any comments, anybody? Yes. And the reason we do this one eye thing is, you know, the all-seeing eye and all of those occultic things with the one eye and, you know, so many other things. But that's one thing that we definitely know is something that is not in the covenant of Yah.
Mm-hmm.
And that is actually the opposite of what the Yah Father is saying. Amen?
Amen. The one eye...
Go ahead,
the one eye... monster, whatever he's supposed to be, all seeing eye of what's his face. Basically, it's a mark on scripture because it's really a form of masonry, and also back in back in when they did all this, the early, I think it was during Plato days, and they had an art form that had this. Come here, Jonathan. They had an art form. Like this. See how it's bigger. See, I want you to see how this is. See how that's not, it's not lined up like you got over there. So this is what's coming out. And that's why you have people always calling you saying, get the camera right. You need to get this. This is what's coming on RTM radio.
Jonathan is undergoing a tutorial. Very good.
Go ahead, man. Go ahead. Now, the all-seeing eye they put in there. Remember we talked about the magic thing?
Yes.
And how that they try to get most people to agree with it, mm-hmm. and to see what's going on and all this and that. The diamond even is a form of it. And what happens with that when they stick it in, like Elder said, subliminal messages, when they stick it in the subliminal message, it gets in your mind whether you want to or not. Mm-hmm. And like I was going to the point as where they slapped Yeshua in the face because Yeshua wasn't sense, was a mason. He was a carpenter, but they really had blocks.
Yeah.
And so that's why they come up with masons and all this and that, because they think they're directly doing what Yeshua did and makes them special.
Mm-hmm.
But that's why I say it's kind of like a slap, because he said don't make no graven images of them and all this and that.
Yeah.
And they use the eye for all kinds of foolishness. And also, it's also a lot of Masonic images. A lot of them now is just for Masonic. Then you have those that cross over into the bridge of occultic.
Yeah.
And a lot of people that are in the Masonic lodge don't have no idea that is occultic. Mm-hmm. And so that's what get them in trouble.
Yes.
So.
Yes.
Come on, give y'all a hand for that good explanation. You know, sometimes we forget why we find these things, why we're looking for them, and we need these reminders. Next slide.
I had never heard of this pet food when I was in Orlando, but I keep seeing these commercials here. And they got
double
kind of images, as you can see.
Yes.
I guess whoever
has
a pet, they want to try to get in on it too. Yes. Yes. You can. You see? I guess that's a combination of the sun with faces and stars, like what we're talking about, the great images.
Yes, indeed. That's a beautiful. Come on, give y'all a hand for that. And you know. I was so glad you put that on here, Elder Mel, because I saw the commercials a couple of times here. And I was like, what in the world? You know? And they just putting it all over the place.
Is this a commercial?
Yeah, this is a new line. This is a line of pet food. And the commercial comes on, and you know, the dog, they're saying, isn't this the one that said that to, they are part of your family, talking about feed them, you want to feed them the best or something? They're one of your children or something like that.
I didn't know they sold it in Orlando, and I really didn't pay attention to the wording, number one, because I'm not that lover, and number two, because when it starts to change, the commercial came home, so I pulled it out.
Okay, I think this is the one where they, and actually this is what caught my attention when they were saying something about you wouldn't feed your kids something. Anyway, they were equating the animal to like a family member, to a child.
Yeah.
Like the dog is one, you know, the pet is a family member, but it's not a human. It's not supposed to be treated, but they were putting it up there, and then when they popped that the dog going to eat the food and then that sun and the moon combination there, I was like, ooh! So I'm so glad you brought that. I mean, you shared that.
I want to share a commercial.
Okay. When Eddie, want to get it in?
Yeah,
is
it in?
Huh?
No.
Oh, I forgot.
This one over.
Okay. All right. Next slide. Good stuff.
Oh, I don't really have any comments on that. I just happened to be at the library and know the devil. Somebody, they had to know what that stands for. We
yes.
Here, but you don't just put something like that on the plate and not know what it's for. So.
Yeah. Yes.
Yes, y'all see that? What's on the license plate?
Yep.
The next slide, I inserted some additional info on that elbow nail. So, and I'm like you, they had to know what that meant, especially when you get to that last slide.
The devil, five devils.
Yeah. Minister
and
one.
It was interesting too. We made me think because we say on the back of the car in Illinois, like a lot of states, but we don't have it in Florida. They have it on the back in the front license plate too. They have back and front is the same thing. So you see it in the front and the back.
Oh wow! Wow.
So the devil hit you coming and going. The devil missed. Ooh, whoa, they had to know. Minister Buono, yeah, if you would read that next slide that's is connected with Elder Linnell's picture.
Yes.
We recently released Deborah, a tuneful. Her cockhead, the devil. Green moon pilots who came out at night carrying a torch, accompanied by devil dolls. She was said to frequent crossroads where statues to her were erected. A triple goddess, she was sometimes pictured as having the heads of a devil dog, a horse, and a serpent. Was paid tribute on nights of the full moon by leaving offerings at her devil statue. As queen of the night, the devil, Hecate, ruled spirits, ghosts, and infernal devil creatures such as devil ghouls. She was the pigness of devil witchcraft.
Woo! Yes, thank you, man. Thank you, Minister Buono. See that last line there, patron of the witchcraft. I'm Ellenelle, I'm like you, they had to know what that meant. That's, I was like, you have got to be kidding me. Well, there you go. And the next line says, I told you Ellenelle win all the prizes. She found some good stuff.
Oh, this was another one that had absolutely nothing to do with the main thing, which was the movie Flash. I don't know if people saw the movie, but she had different tattoos on her back and her hand, and they just kept subtly throwing her hand in, even though it had absolutely nothing to do with the picture. So I don't know if you can see it or not, but basically it's a moon and some stars on her hand.
Amen. Come on, give a hand. And it's not just any moon, it's a crescent moon. Yes. And that is, I was looking at the picture going, come on now. You don't see the need, you saw her hand because you're trying to figure out what is that on her hand. And then you don't even notice that there's somebody laid there until much later.
Well, yeah, go. Your subconscious knows that, it sees it all. And, they could go picture on picture, layers of pictures, and they could be having a graphic pornography scene about it, you'd never know.
Wow.
And that's one reason I think, and I pretty much think I'm right, that they're pushing so much 3D.
Yeah.
Because 3D, you know, you got layers and layers of pictures, and then if it's not programmed in, it's basically you ain't gonna see it, it's natural.
Mm-hmm.
But your subconscious is picking all this up. People don't understand how you can be sitting up and then one minute you just find next minute, man, I'm so thirsty.
Mm-hmm.
Man, I'm so hungry. You know, and it's amazing because it has been proven by science.
Yeah.
Over and over and over and over again. You will get more results fooling with people's subconscious than you do just outright saying. You know, outright saying, go buy a Pepsi, or outright saying, go buy a Coke, whatever.
Yeah.
Instead of outright saying it, if you put it, just let it roll across the bottom of the screen.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's what they do with news and stuff. Just let it roll across the bottom of the screen. Your subconscious picking all that up. And then you'd be like, I wonder how UCF doing this year.
Yes.
And that's called scores of sports. Just can't shoot the ball.
Wow.
And they know that to be true because it's so conscious. It soaks in, and then, you know, for people, especially people who aren't disciplined and hearing from the spirit and discerning the soul from the spirit and from they just do whatever they think. Mm-hmm. And they just go with it. And there's on.
Yeah.
So this one.
Wow.
Think about it, interesting.
Yes.
Wow, that's good stuff. Come on, give y'all a hand for that. Yes. Yes, go ahead.
I didn't share how because what was that word that they was teaching us the importance of brand for this company and you know how to keep the integrity of brand. You said there's a lot of counselors out there and stuff like that. And then in the class that we and they showed a picture of seven different toothpaste. And if you can just picture the toothpaste boxes back on top of each other, and all of them had different logos, like the first one had the logo of Reese's candy, you know, the brown and the orange, and one had the logo of the Life Savers with different candy colors. But if you look closer at all seven of those, and how many they had toothpaste, each, all of them had the word Crest, and it's Crest, Florida, they needed toothpaste, or something like that. And basically, the moral of what he's trying to tell us is it doesn't matter what words you put on the package, that image is there so strong and they put it in front of you so many different times that it's branded into your brain that you're going to pick up whatever that product is, regardless of what words they put on it. And I just thought that was so true, and you know what Pastor was just talking about. You know, they put it into your brain and it's stuck there no matter how hard you try to wash it out.
Wow.
And then when you add music on top of it. Come on, give y'all a hand for this information. But if you have that, I was thinking if you have that, all of that going on and then there's some music influential in addition to it, it makes it worse.
Yeah, it would make it worse. Yeah, but music is, I'm trying to say it right here. Images stick to your brain, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's a different part of the network of the brain. The eyes are taking in the sight, and it sticks. It's like a film left over with a camera. And you take pictures and you look at stuff. Although that negative, you know, we throw ours with it.
Uh-huh.
That's not going anywhere in your brain. It's going to be stuck there.
Yeah.
You know, you can pray all you want to, you shouldn't look there.
Wow.
The only way you defeat it is you have to put more good in your mind than bad. Because they're out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaking.
Yes.
And people don't understand. I heard one man talking about the difference between the heart and the mind.
Yeah.
And he was saying the heart is where your decision making is made.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, no, the heart is where information is stored.
Mm-hmm.
The reasoning is in the mind.
Yeah.
When you think, you contemplate things, you contemplate that with your mind. That's the reason.
Mm-hmm.
And your heart is like a just full of everything. Everything you see, everything you hear, it goes in that slot.
Mm-hmm.
And you filter it with the mind, the mindset you have. You know, heart is a lot of emotions.
Yeah.
But you filter it out with your mind, and that's why you have the scripture said you have to renew your mind.
Yes.
And he comes in and he renew your thinking. You renew your mind, and that's that thinking. You know, thinking differently.
Yes.
And the difference with that with music goes not only to the heart, but it permeates to the soul.
Wow, wow.
It goes down there, and it's like going through your whole being.
Yeah.
Because everything you are is meant to praise. It meant, you are like a living song.
Yeah.
You just want to sing. If there's not a human being in the world that do not want to express themselves in the form of a rhythmatic song.
Yeah.
That's, everything is built upon singing. And there, everything is a lot. That's what we want to do. That's why animals howl. You know, that minus wrote a song. Everything you touch is a song.
Yes.
People don't realize that animals, they be singing. They have to Everything would move to a rhythmatic.
Yeah.
And the wind wanna say something, it'll come by and knock on the wings.
Yes. Yes.
It's that anything that's alive
uh-huh.
that has that ability to move according to the frequency and to express itself.
Yeah.
It's like saying, we're here.
Yes.
We're here. Human beings, they just don't know what's happening.
Yeah.
Because we one of the few, we are the only creatures
mm-hmm.
that have the DNA of God.
Mm-hmm.
But we few are on this planet, very few living beings can think like we can.
Yeah.
We can choose what we say,
mm-hmm.
and the rhythm and the tone we're going to use. And what they do, especially in art classes,
uh-huh.
they try to filter out the good and get the people to express evil. Even if you don't want to sing, they'll come in there and they'll get you to move to the rhythm that's not there, but it's there.
Yeah.
You know, because they've been playing a whole bunch of stuff before you got in there, and that stuff is left in the room.
Yeah.
And you come in and you pay, they'll let them pay with their eyes closed and all that. They do that to children.
Yeah.
Express yourself in your inner thoughts. And then within the picture, you see a large, you know, I don't know, let's say a large snicker.
Mm-hmm.
But the snicker look kind of funny.
Yeah.
And then it looked almost like, and you'd be like, that ain't no snicker.
Yeah.
You know, and that's how that stuff works.
Yeah.
Wow. That's a lot.
That, come on now, y'all. That's some good stuff right there. Yes. Thank you, Father. Oh, man. Any other comments on that before we move to the next one? That's some good stuff. It reminded me of one of the books, Piercing the Darkness, this present darkness, one of them, when child, they were giving children like that. Who, voice in the sky, who was that said? Was there a voice in the sky?
I said, I agree.
Okie dokies! Yes, next slide. Click! Yes, another fine. El O'Neill, I'm telling you, y'all, El O'Neill won all the prizes.
That's another, I wasn't even looking for those, but it just stood out because we were stuck in, you know, the moon day. And I guess it's some kind of snack bar called Luna with the parents of Luna.
Good find. The what? The pastor Luna?
That thing in the upper right corner. What is that?
That's another product. I thought that too. I was like, what? That looks kind of weird. You see the product to the right?
No, still on the normal.
Oh.
Top.
Oh, yes.
See, on my screen, it's
a gotcha. Little,
I don't even know what that is.
You see, he's talking about on the box with the Luna?
A.
The whatever that is on the A part.
One is go to A and the column climb down to the A.
Yes. Y'all hear Pastor?
Yeah.
This does look kind of freaky, Nikki.
Anybody know what that is?
Anybody know what that is?
I don't
know. That's crazy. I don't know why not. This thing jacked up over here. It's crazy. Oh, that's a number four. That's a number four. Now, I want to ask you something. That's a ribbon black thing. You see where that four at? Y'all can see that because on RTM, you can't see it on RTM.
Yeah.
It's really jacked up. I don't know what's up on RTM. There you go. Now, I want to, you see that?
Uh-huh.
Now, I want you to notice this. How many ribbons or things have you seen that kind of curve to the front?
Yeah.
At the very front, it curves around.
Wow. None.
None, because in the back, it's like circumcision. It's like a circumcision.
Show
I'm not trying to look at it, and
wow.
I'm telling you what it is. If you look at it, it got lines on it like it has been circumcised, and it rounds around. It goes around. So don't just come down and square off to the bottom.
Yeah.
Like flat. It's got an arch in it. And the other, and those, I don't even know what those things are, those little irrigated letters that went around, making up a circle, like a circumcision. You see my stuff in here? That nasty looking chocolate bar? I've been 20 years on this right here.
Good find, right? I got a piece of tissue. Trying to, yes.
I got a piece of tissue on the screen trying to point to the general area where it's at. But that my finger looking sort of like a snake head or something. Yes. Brother Jonathan is going to stick his little finger over there.
Right up on the chip is an upside down triangle.
On the which one?
See where your hand at? On your pointing crazy?
Yes.
That one, bro. Your fingers don't live right, something wrong. But right up on there is a sign, it's a thing that says chip. Like it's a chocolate chip.
Uh-huh.
Right up on the H and the I is an upside down triangle.
Wow.
Now, what in the world is that for? And why on the lunar we have to have a world full of chocolate? What's that all about?
A whirlpool of chocolate?
Yeah, you see that thing going around like a that chocolate swirling around in a circle? See,
oh, yes, I
see.
On top
that.
Of peanuts or something?
Yeah, like a black hole.
Yes.
So they got a vortex.
Yes.
That's what I'm looking for.
Wow.
You can't make much money.
So it was a lot.
Now look between, I'm sure you're the expert now, this is the expert. You ready for this?
Uh-oh.
You see where that C at on the moon?
The C on the moon. Mm-hmm. Uh-oh.
See, the moon is a C, right?
Yeah.
You see, right in the middle of that U,
uh-huh.
Go toward the end, and use the moon as a line, and follow it up to the crescent, and tell me what you see. Everyone else see it. I mean, that's just ridiculous.
Oh, that's ridiculous.
Follow the everybody else in. You see? You see?
No.
Right here. I get it. Look at the U. The U is cut in half by the C. Good close up there, Jonathan. And follow it on up, just use the moon as the cutoff point. Between the U and the, see that space between them?
Uh-huh.
Now just go on, just look, follow the moon or tell me what you see. Now what you say,
Parents
magazine
did
the marketing for this. Boy. Okay. I got it. Boy. I mean.
I think I got it.
See? I mean.
Yeah.
Look. You go as far. Say this is like a leg coming down with a man standing up between the two and the blank right here.
Oh!
And then you got this.
What? They need to be shaming
this.
They need to be shaming this stuff, boy.
I see. I mean, all of that it's done like that on purpose.
It's true, though.
They
put anywhere on that bar.
Yeah, they did it on purpose.
Yeah.
And see, you have within the A, you have triangles. You got triangles. Everything is done to illuminate a triangle. See.
Yeah.
It's squared off into a triangle. But the U comes around, and you got this coming down, and then you have this.
Boy.
If you stand straight up, you'll be right here. Right, lined up with this line.
Boy.
And that ain't no nose.
Boy. That makes me
mad. Okay, I've been hanging around past too long. It's right over the word nut.
Yep.
Boy.
since you're talking about that, drop down under the end, go straight down to that little, what that little piece of chocolate bit off right there.
My God, this is messy.
Woo! And if you really want to look at something, just look at, like how Johnny got there, just turn your head to the side. Back up, Johnny. Back up.
Damn, it just takes a minute.
Okay, stop. Go down some. Back up so I can see the whole thing. I know how full you is now. I'm going to start working. Okay. Come up to the bottom where you can't see the peanuts. You can leave it there. Just leave it there. Now turn your head to the side. Erase all the writing. And just leave that little chocolate there. And turn your head to the side. And you see this horizon up here? That fades in and out. And you follow it on down. And you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 fingers holding something.
What?
Did anybody see that?
Boy! Why you had to put the peanuts like that? You know what you were doing.
Different box.
50 different things. Exactly. One box.
Y'all see it at home? One of the best saying that.
Yeah, Minister, what's your name is? Commissioner Mary has a hand up.
Go ahead.
And you notice one of the peanuts, the one that's furthest out?
Mm-hmm.
It looks like a female part.
Yep.
Boy.
They do.
They need a woman.
This,
one box. 50
different. Russ Johnson said it. He said one box with 50 different things on it. That's just a box of evil.
Now, you want to look at that?
No, side? That's where I'm at.
You go down to that 6 down there?
I don't have to change that funky thing.
You go down to the 6 down there?
I'm being kind of sick.
You see the 6?
Yeah.
You see the blank space that's supposed to be blank? See what that is?
What is it?
It's the same thing that's in here. No, that's even more. That's even more like a female. My computer wasn't closed up here to the top. See, this 6. I'm ready for the other 6. You got 666 down there. There you go.
Boy.
666.
Boy.
Come here. All day box, 666.
So ill.
Now, where you found this at?
The child that's at Walmart. You did just hit the boy.
Oh, that made me weak. All 3 boxes. Y'all saw that 666.
Oh yeah.
Well, I got something down there so we can see 666. Unless you don't die, you can do it now. It's trying to make it a triangle.
Wow.
The 1, 6, 9, 5.
LNL, I kind of don't think you knew you had found such that much in that, did you?
No, I put this 5, 6, 5
whole seconds. Yes. Bob Johnson got something. Go ahead.
Speaking of the number 6, we were watching America's Home Plays videos. I don't know why. They could just have it as one large 6 instead of having 3 6s. They had it on a screen because they were playing these 6 videos of very funny things, and then they had one screen with the 6, another screen with the 6, and the other screen.
at the six.
Coincidence?
Together.
Coincidence?
I think not!
Boy.
Come on, y'all. Give y'all a hand for all that he's, man. Let me give it to us. Boy, that's some expert deciphering right there for real. What's the L now?
Let's move on, because that is really
next slide. Is
this supposed to be chocolate, though? I don't know. Is it some kind of energy bar?
Someone already opened it.
I think it's supposed to be some kind of energy or protein bar or something.
It was with the medicine.
Oh, man. I know what the Cliff Bar is.
It was with the medicine.
In the pharmacia section? Pharmacia, which means, Yes, right there.
Ooh, that's 5 miles ago, ain't it, Pastor?
Huh?
Right there.
About what?
Five slides ago.
I don't know. I was working. I don't know what y'all doing. But see, you see the woman here, she's holding something. And you see how it comes out into a person making a V with the other hand? That V will always be for vagina. And the kneecap, that's going to be a kneecap, it circles around, then it disappears into the darkness, so you no longer see it. The only thing you have is from her finger on up. You don't have this part up here, nor do you have this part over here. You just got a big, giant fabric going into her vagina. With her hand, she holds. That's why they did that. They was
with her hands.
Huh?
You said that's why they did with her hands?
Yeah, that's what that is all about. That has nothing to do with tattoos. You probably focus in on tattoos, but this is what when you're here. Y'all said you just wonder why.
All right, can we move on?
And so this is where we're at?
Yes. Let me move back to the... Tell me when I get there, Brother Jonathan. Okay.
This one is a tidbit. This part right here. You have to write on it because it's a rated R.
Wow. Y'all heard what she said? Going back to the hand, she said the pastor was right on it because it led to a rated R scene. Well, I tell you.
That's one of the values.
Ooh. I'm going to just hit Commissioner Amira. Go. And the lady that played in that movie, I saw her one day on the red carpet wearing a see-through shirt with no bra on. So, yeah. There you go. There you go. So all the business is
there.
Yes, that's some voice of wisdom that came across.
If you put that in my mind, that's the devil. The devil is there.
Whoa.
Yes, brother. I believe you's right. Pastor, you got something to say on the salt thingy bee bee bee?
I'm not saying nothing else for you.
And LMS says they are all over the city, right? That's what jumped out at me when you were talking about it. And that's what they keep the salt in. I mean, why you can't put the salt in a square building?
Well, I understand because of snow. You gotta slide down. You don't want to build up the snow on the top, so you make it come up to a point. What I don't understand is why you got this point thing right here coming out like it comes out, and then has a long object going in and out of this thing right here.
That's what he's talking about.
It's good. It's good.
Y'all see the things he's talking about?
Yeah.
This ramp and.
I mean, you can position stuff so many different ways. This stuff is, I mean, purposely done. And beating the minds of the people up there. Go ahead, Commissioner. Wouldn't it make more sense to put that whole looking thing down more because the salt's falling instead of up that high like that? It would make more sense for them not to just do the opposite of what y'all said to do. That's what, you know what I mean? This
well, yeah, look, if the snow then, say the snow rises a couple of inches,
yeah,
halfway, they still got room to work with.
Mm-hmm.
But I just think it's poison.
Oh my goodness. All right, let's move on to the next one.
Click.
I can't do
this. I think that's. Is that Brother Jonathan's?
Yep.
And then shall you speak on it, Brother Jonathan?
Wait, what's that?
Yes. So what is it? What is it? What is it? What is it? He's thinking. He forgot what it was. But he said it's evil. Go.
I believe you're watching Superman.
Oh!
The hypnotizing, some kind of hypnotizing device that used those very symbols that are sitting on the screen.
What? The hypnotizing device shot those images?
Yep.
Oh, my God.
Ooh.
Oh, my God. That's why I don't remember.
Boy. Ooh, y'all see that? It's kind of blurry and hard to see, but you can see the sun and the moon face and stuff, right?
And the stars.
And the stars.
I kind of saw it through my mom's hand. I think the stars were spinning in the face. I don't know what the face was doing.
Okay, the stars were spinning in a circle, and the face was going like a so the stars were orbiting, and the sun was vorte. So, yeah. That ain't going to be brain saying, huh?
That's Joseph getting, glad they're playing on Joseph's dream.
Yes, that's good. Y'all heard what Pastor said? It's like I wonder how many stars it is, because he said it's like a play on Joseph's dream. Remember Joseph had a dream where the moon and the sun and the stars bowed down to him?
Yeah.
It's amazing to me how these, a lot of the symbols and stuff like that were, it either, like Pastor said, it's a, they take something of y'all and just say ha 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 at it and twist it to mean something totally different, you know? So many significant things that are in the Word are in the Scriptures, and then they take it and, that made me. All right. Let's move on. What's next? Unless anybody else got anything to say on that one? Go ahead.
Yeah.
Say it again.
Yeah. I'll see
it
again.
All
I have to say is look out for stuff like this. Because it's evil.
Brother Jonathan is feeling his oats today. He wants everyone to look out for stuff like that. And that's what just what we're doing. This is what this is all about. This exercise is all about. To sharpen your skills. All right, put the mic down. Yes, we feel mighty happy. Yes. All right, did I click it? Did I go to the next one? All right.
Revelations. Revelations 92.
Ah, somebody read that for me. Read that scripture, please. Commissioner. Revelation 9:2. And he opened the bottomless pit, and there rose a smoke out of the pit, as the smoke of a great furnace, and the sun and the air were darkened by reason of the smoke of the pit. Let's see what comes up next. I hope I got it in the right order.
It's a second.
See those black things? Someone read the caption overhead, Brother Jonathan.
The bottom of the two black spots of the sun, known as sunspots, appeared quickly over the course of February 19, 2013. These two sunspots are part of the same system and are over six Earths across.
Six Earths. Across. I think so. I think he said he had two.
Three spots.
Yeah.
So that's six.
Did you hear that?
No.
Oops.
That's a bunch of things. Why did he say that?
So, you know, six. Well, I'm telling you, y'all better be, woo! Yeah, the Father is showing a lot of stuff happening. Anybody got any comments on that before we click to the next one?
And the spots form a triangle.
Yes, it's important to know the times that we're living in. Commissioner O'Meara? And just to add what Minister Wanda said, the spots form the triangle and it's over the lightest part of the sun, Illuminati.
I don't know if y'all can see it, but I see a wolf silhouette.
Yep.
I'm telling you, though, yes.
These are like horns, and there's also a couple of phallics.
Yep. Y'all hear pastors, it's horns, also a couple of phallics. I'm telling you, like with the other previous sun images, too, I was seeing a lot of different creature-y looking shapes and stuff.
Don't mean much because you could see shapes in a lot of things. Like you go down to the bottom, you see a hand. Then you go up there, but that middle like a phallic coming around out of that top triangle. Like you got a triangle, upside down triangle, and you got a phallic and you got a wolf head on top of it. And all of those are great, 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 I mean great, powerful demonic symbols. It's uncanny, and I'm blown away by the fact that this is on the sun. This is amazing to me. If this wasn't here, you know, I'd be like, okay. But that is, and for somebody to catch it,
yeah.
You know, it's crazy. It's honestly blowing my mind. Because what I was going to share, I think now is a good time to share it, was a commercial with, the guy puts on cologne and he walks around with two wolves on his shoulder. And the girl goes up to the girl. The girl said, she's talking like, she's telling the story. She's commentary. And she said, he walks in. And he got two wolves on his shoulder. She over there with her husband. I'm eating dinner with my husband. I'm sitting with him in the car. I didn't stand a chance. And in between that, it's flashing forward stuff real fast. She said, I didn't stand a chance. And in between all the stuff, the wolf would look at her and growl.
Yeah.
And say something. He got two, not one, but two wolves on his shoulder. And then he goes over there and she ends up going home with him in the car. Mm. And the wolves are still on his shoulder. He's like, yeah, we did a good job.
Yeah.
And she was like, I never stood a chance. And that was just crazy.
Yeah.
Stripping down, like, hey, this is demonic. This is a spell, I guess. This is a charm. And then the car salesmen now, they sell into wolves and dogs. One commercial, he tells the woman, that's a wolf car, and that's it. All of a sudden, a wolf. I mean,
yes.
Where is, all of a sudden, you're talking about werewolves.
Yes.
You know, they get just as big as vampires.
Yep.
Now. I know everybody knows about the movie, whatever, Twilight.
Mm-hmm.
But it's just out of control. It's
yep.
Just,
it really is.
And when you do the history, you do a little bit of study on vampires and werewolves. They've been around for the longest of time.
Mm-hmm.
And some people think they're the one and the same. They're
wow.
Both of them have fangs.
Mm-hmm.
Both of them, you know, come out at night.
Mm-hmm.
Both of them turn into an animal. Vampire, aka a bat.
Mm-hmm.
Both of them eat humans, vampire blood, werewolf, human. They go ahead and say it's the same thing, just different different manifestations of the same
wow.
form. When the satanic rituals, they're different, they're complete different. One of them is actually turned into an animal, and the other one changes form because of the food that they're eating, which is blood. Some of them still eat food, but they take most of the blood and turn pale, and they do that, you know, as a form of fasting to the devil or whatnot. They get these
spirits inside of them that were charmed by the spirit. But it's just crazy. The fullness of what is happening.
Yes. Yes. Come on.
Give y'all a hand for that. That's, yes. I'm glad you said that too, because when you were talking earlier and you mentioned that how, I think you were talking about the 3D movies and how a lot of these things, oh yeah, if you don't have that self-control, you walk around like zombies. And it's like zombie stuff is invading everywhere too. And they got these things on to make yourself a zombie. You know how you can cartoon yourself? Well, they got these things now, you see your picture and it says zombie you or something. I'm like, you know, this is just evil.
Yeah.
It's just zombie, I'm like, that just crossed the line of evil, that's not fun, that's just evil. But yeah, I'm glad you said that, Pastor. And I was blown away when you said that about I saw these and it's like, this something's just not right about these. You know, something in these pictures. And so then when you said that, it just really shook me a bit. Come on, we got some more images, I believe, after this. Let's go to the next one.
What that one is?
Oh, okay. What is? What's the title?
Nancy sees monster sometimes growing.
Okay. Fast. Thank you. That's the That's the article that connects with that image. I don't want us to read it. I just wanted you to have it there for your reference. If you want to go back and read it, but it talks about the. How quickly they came about, and just put a bit more information in it. Would you do it, guess?
What?
What's this? What's the next one? You got a, that's a scripture?
Yeah.
Read that for me, somebody. Read the Revelation.
Missionary word?
Revelations 12:9, and the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil and Satan, which deceived the whole world. He was cast out into the earth, and his angels were cast out with him.
Yes.
That's the scripture I was referring to earlier.
And I
think we have images that are next. Click.
What is it?
Yes. Now, come on now.
Wow. Wow.
You want to jump and read the caption for me?
This still from a NASA video shows the New Year's Eve sun eruption of December 31, 2012 to kick off New Year's NASA Solar Dynamics Observatory, I would say, captured the video.
That one minute it looks like a phoenix, the next minute it looks like a dragon head, you know.
It's got a face.
Yeah. Any comments?
Anybody have to shrug them off and say that's what it's neat to have their head exam. I mean, seriously, look at that.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's about as clear as Chris. That's about as clear as you can get.
Yeah.
I mean, seriously, they all they need now is a Pixar movie, and it'd be, that might make it a little bit clearer.
Yeah. Yep. Like two-headed almost, right?
Yeah. Commissioner was saying she saw two faces. It's like, man. Next image. What is it? Oh, that's another one. I thought it was pretty. I got the link to some of these pictures on there because it's just so many freaky deaky pictures. But notice that little shiny star thingy. That was from a sunspot or something. Somebody read that caption for me. I think it says what it is.
This still from a NASA video shows the New Year's Eve sun eruption of December 31st, 2012. To kick off New Year's, NASA Solar Dynamics Observatory captured the video. NASA Solar Dynamics Observatory satellite captured this photo of X-class solar flare unleashed from the sun October 22, 2012.
Okay, so that's a solar flare. I think it's the lens or something. They on how they're looking at the plasma, because there's other pictures in here that they talk about the different colors. It's different colors and stuff anyway. Anyway, here you go. But you can see the star on that and how bright that little spot is. That's why I wanted to put that in there. It's like something open. Next picture? What is it? Yes. Come on now. Minister Buona, what you got to say? Yes. It does look like a snake. My pastor said it's a snake. It sure looked like a snake. That old servant.
The Chinese talk about dragons, you know, a lot of the Chinese, I think, dragons. I might get it back, but one of the Japan dragons don't have wings, and I think one of them got more feet than the other one. And they were like big giant snakes and lizards. The snake more in one country. One country they were like big giant lizards. In one country they were like big giant snakes. Just like in America, we talk about dinosaurs as if they were real. They talk about dragons as if they were real. And they're saying that they come from dragons.
Yeah.
And it would be just like Americans, people in European, think they came from tadpoles, or think they came from a drop of mud. And, you know, really, in the theory of evolution and whatnot, and why it's a theory, because they never can make up a good enough line of thick.
Yes!
There are different types of mankind, different types of human beings. You know, we're going to the home of this and the home of that.
Yeah.
In the Justice League universe, DC universe, there is this one caveman who got before this meteor, and he slept there all night because it was cold, and he woke up. It's highly intelligent. It's only Dune, if you ever seen Dune. That one, the Homo sapiens, that was a different type of human being, according to this big theory. Of course, in Yah, he made humans. He made human beings, and then he made mankind. He made mankind, which is another type of human beings. And I've been saying for years, when you read scripture, it tells you that there's two different types of human beings on the earth. That's a lot out of life. And then you have a group over that father didn't want the Israelites or the Hebrews to mess with. He didn't want their DNA with that, because they were an abomination to him. And that's because of things like this. We forget, I keep telling people that every seed got to produce after its own kind. And we're spirits, so we can make these spirits. They're talking about the DNA, they're talking about humans, you know, combining humans with animals. And for years they thought it wasn't possible until they put an animal heart in the man and he lived. And then they start adding more different things to human. And they live, you know, and this stuff, I don't think it's right, but that's just my opinion. But I think it's an abomination based on what Yah says.
Yeah.
I don't know about a heart, but you know, you look at it, well, okay, it's just gonna, like when they told me, it was going to give me chicken something.
Crown.
Whether they're going to stick it in my knee to grow back my cardio stuff. And I thought about it for a while, but I wasn't going to do it at first because I thought they was, you know, giving me animal DNA. Mm-hmm. But, you know, I started looking at it like the father said, like, I'm eating it, because it's digested down and put into it, and it's be like me eating and they give it to my phone. So I was looking at it like that. You know, it ain't like I'm becoming a chicken, but you know.
Yes.
That's how I looked at it. Like, I ain't finna combine no stuff with me just so I can, especially a chicken, you know, being chicken legs.
Yeah.
You know, if you're gonna give me some legs, give me some bull legs or
yes.
somebody, a cheetah leg, somebody that can run fast.
Yes.
You know, but there were leopard men, scripture Paul,
yeah.
leopard men, there were men. I'm like,
yeah.
you know, and when you see something like this, we always assume that you know, there is nothing living inside the sun because it's hot.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure fish on the bottom of the ocean don't think there's no life up there on that.
Yeah.
How can they live up there in that heat?
Yes.
You know, the polar bear, they're like, man, I ain't going down there in the hot sun.
Yeah. Yes.
So, you know, where we're at is hot to some people.
Mm-hmm.
I'm saying this for a reason, because I know things can take the form of certain things, you know, but I don't think this is no coincidence. I'm not saying that is a snake.
Mm-hmm.
I'm saying it looks like a snake. But all I know is Yah put stuff sealed, and he sealed it.
Yes.
He sealed it in the earth, and then also the earth just means ground. Every time you see earth, it don't mean the planet earth.
There you go.
You know, so if you go to Jupiter or some other place, I don't know what kind of solid stuff that would be.
Mm-hmm.
I'm pretty sure they ain't have no word for it.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
You know, how you gonna put it where, and I say that all the time, where is a bottomless pit in the earth?
Yeah.
I know you get down and get to the core, and the core of the earth is liquid, magma.
Mm-hmm.
And stuff like that, and then you start going back up again. That I do know.
Mm-hmm.
But that ain't the picture that is being, you know, put him in a cave and throw a rock on it, and he won't be able to move.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I mean, you know, this is an archangel.
Yeah.
Whatever, you know, and he didn't say that. Isaiah, yeah. And Isaiah, I mean, come on, that's one of the big boys.
See?
But you're going to let Beelzebub and Satan run around loose?
Mm.
And you're going to lock up Isaiah?
Mm.
To him, you know, I'm like, we think we know so much. But what if it, I said, what if the sun is a lake of fire? That's what I said.
Yeah.
That's the query I propose. Because there are huge suns out there. I mean,
yes.
Ridiculous suns out there. Man, I got pictures of them.
Yes.
So, I mean, what if the sun is what he meant by the lake of fire?
Yeah.
You know, and that's the problem. But what if he locked them up in the sun?
Yeah.
Now, everybody knows the sun goes to earth road.
Yes.
You know, and we think we know what the heavenlies is. Mm. They done not sit down and told us that the atmosphere is the heavenlies.
Mm-hmm.
It's the first heaven. Ain't nobody sit down and said there was only three heavens.
Mm-hmm.
Ain't nobody told nobody nothing about that. Mm-hmm. Ain't nobody told them there was seven. I don't know, a demon might have came and talked to them and told them there was seven heavens.
Uh-huh.
But the scriptures, Paul said he was in the third heavens, and then we ran with it and said, well, there's only three heavens.
Yes.
I mean, and you look at how this solar system is.
Yes.
I even look at the solar system.
Man.
It was the same. That when he meant first heaven, he didn't mean solar system.
Exactly. Yes.
All these planets are void of life that we know.
Uh-huh.
And they're destroyed. Maybe Satan, like they said, was in charge of them.
Mm-hmm.
And then they done found two more planets.
Yes.
All of a sudden appeared in the solar system.
Yes.
And all of a sudden appeared.
Okay.
When I was watching this man this morning, I get bored. He said they did the measurements of New Jerusalem.
Mm-hmm.
He said it would be the walls of New Jerusalem
mm-hmm.
would go from Canada
uh-huh.
to Colorado.
Wow.
Do you know how far that is?
Wow.
I think he said Quebec, Canada to Colorado. I'm like,
wow.
He said, this is the walls to one city.
Wow.
This is nothing better than New World.
Wow.
I don't think people understand what I'm saying. But everybody think, and I was, I said, man, there's billions and billions of people that live on this earth, live on this planet. Why in the world all of us gonna stay on one planet?
Yeah.
And everybody told you to stand on that planet.
So it.
But the way this universe is situated, it's, like I said before, it's like a jail. It's either highly protected or it's a consecration camp.
Yes.
And you got all these rocks. It's impossible to get through.
Yes.
Physically, it's impossible. If you leave this dimension and you say, well, I'm going back to planet Earth, and you're alive, you ain't going to be alive when you get back. Even if you could stop time. I mean,
yeah.
The radiation alone will eat you alive. Mm-hmm. I mean, you got the Van Allen belt. You got the asteroid belt.
Yes.
You got the, it ain't like the Earth is just saying, come on, get me.
Yes.
Why you think all those rocks, by the time they hit the Earth, are so small?
Mm-hmm.
They don't flew all the way in space, over trillions and trillions of miles, and try to evade the Earth and get it to turn into a pebble.
Yes.
They're highly upset. They thought they were going to destroy something.
Yes.
I'm serious, you know.
Yes.
Don't want me to worry about no asteroid hitting us. It would take a plan. It would take a plan. You know what it takes for them to go through all that stuff?
Man.
It would take a plan to come down and knock us out, or a someone that can think. An inanimate object is not just going randomly destroy life on Earth. I don't believe that because I see the way the atmosphere we're moving target. You're not be standing still.
Yeah.
We're moving target, and then you gotta go around all that stuff. That's some serious. You got some serious aiming.
Okay. That's highly improbable. Come on, y'all, give me a hand. Good information. Yes. And I'm clicking to the next slide. What we got? Click. What we got?
Yeah.
Now this was a freaky dicky one. I wanted to make sure I put that on there. See the colors and all that stuff? It says, I believe that's the one that says that the color thing that's over there, it's like branching over from one sunspot to the next. Somebody read that caption for me. Mr. Women, Brother MT, if you're with us, come on, I ain't heard you. Would you read that, please?
I'm sorry, say again.
Can you read that caption over that colorful picture for me, please?
Pinkish purple filament of hot plasma connecting two sunspots in this ultraviolet view recorded by NASA Solar Dynamics Observatory spacecraft on August 4th, 2012.
Okay, I just thought that was so interesting or so freaky looking. The plasma going from one sunspot to the next. Come on now.
Is it greedy? Blood transfusion?
Blood transfusion. Yes. All right. Click into the next one. Click. What we got?
Verse.
What is it?
Verse.
Oh.
It's a whole bunch of words from now on.
Okay, words from now on. I'm going to turn my computer around so that I can see the words from now on. So I have the link on there if you want to take a look at some of the other pictures there. I'm telling you, there's some very interesting shots on there. I just didn't want to clog the thing up with all those pictures. But the next slide in the news, and this I saw.
saw this, I said, you know what, this is a trip. And remember our pastor told us about those vaccines, right? Y'all there?
Yeah.
The slide says, in the news, this is the headline, it says, in U.S., flu vaccine worked in just over half of those who got it.
Yes.
Get your flu vaccine today. Get your flu vaccine today.
I got one question.
Yes.
How do you know it worked?
You know what? That's a good question. You all heard he said?
Yep.
How do you know it worked?
Just because you don't get the flu, I don't know it worked.
Exactly. Because they probably wouldn't have got the flu if they didn't get this vaccine. They were saying, I put the link to the article in there, and I just kind of skimmed over it, but it was talking about the people that, most of the people that it didn't work on were the elderly. And did they tell the elderly to get it? Mm-hmm. Yeah. And they were saying something about a compromised immune system. In other words, in my mind, when I saw that, so they took the flu vaccine, which made their immune system fight that flu vaccine, which made them more vulnerable to the flu, a strand that they were not vaccinated for. What other stuff?
I got plenty to say.
Pastor, I have a few words to say about this particular slide. How many glad they didn't get the flu vaccine? I am.
First of all.
Yes.
They tore our life.
Yes.
Second of all,
yes.
We already know that, and I said it millions of times, that they guess on which flu strain will go is going to come, which means they have a vaccination to all of them if they want to.
See.
They don't produce all of them for money reasons, mm-hmm. because people got to die. Mm-hmm. You know, they think, human beings actually think they control the circle of life, if you would.
Wow.
People got to die, people got to get sick, because you got to sell medicine, the morgue got to run. If they cure everything, the earth would be too big and everybody would die because it would be too crowded. So they decided that 65 was a great lifespan for everyone to be in.
Boy.
I'm not exaggerating. If you go up, I think it's in Georgia, they got these commandments written by New Agers. They said New Agers, but it's really the quote-unquote Illuminati, what they go by. That's why everybody, all of a sudden, they want to go to what? Lower, cheaper cars to drive in. Because they said, first of all, it was getting too hot. Remember? It was getting too hot. Y'all remember that? Global warming?
Yes.
I remember global warming?
Uh-huh.
How many have been hot lately? It's been freezing. Global warming. Global warming. Global warming. The polar caps melting. That's called Earth cycle. It's been doing that forever. They already knew that. But they decided to make money off of it.
Yes.
Al Gore became a billionaire off of it. Don't get me started on this day. Now I'm the one, and I could testify to it. What word right have you got to talk to a pastor? I never had pneumonia.
Yep.
Not one time. I never had pneumonia, not once.
Yes.
They said, Mr. McCall, the pneumonia shot is different in the flu shot because you get the pneumonia shot that is predominantly for your condition. So, you know, I could fight off all the other pneumonia, but this one thing that's unique to me having to sleep with a CPAP is they got the prevention for it. So I said, okay, yeah, you know, it's like taking vitamins or whatnot. I get the flu shot, you know, we'll get it once every, I think, 6 years. I get the pneumonia shot, and I've had pneumonia 3 or 4 times since then.
Yeah,
never had a shot in my life, no pneumonia ever. I don't even get colds. I know they're not related, but different virus, but. I get the shot, and I've been in the hospital 3 or 4 times just for the pneumonia. That's backwards.
Yes.
They gave me the disease.
Yes.
Now, when you're talking about this flu vaccination, mm-hmm. this flu vaccination How, now, I want you to tell me, okay, as a living, breathing, thinking person,
yes,
how in the world do a different brand of flu come to America every year,
yes,
and the old brand don't come? How the bird flu, when they had that chicken flu, how did that just stay in China? It didn't,
yes,
go nowhere else. It decided to stay in China.
Yes.
If y'all think that stuff is random, you crazy. They got this stuff now that if you catch a cold. Mm-hmm. Remember the cold was incurable?
Yes.
For years they said it's impossible to cure the common cold. Mm-hmm. Why? Because they needed your money.
Yes.
Cough drops and stuff like that. They got this stuff now because everything is becoming so hard to regulate because people are going to other countries. The Food and Drug Administration can't control everything like it used to. They got this stuff that if you sniff one time,
yes,
and you take this stuff, you will not have a cold. Mm-hmm. Although they say it's not a cure for the common cold. I don't know what you call a cure. But if I take something and,
yes,
and it prevents the thing from coming, that's a cure. If my stomach is hurting and I take something for it, it starts hurting, hey, to me, it stopped the symptom.
You fixed it.
And hey, I ain't got the problem. If you have diarrhea, you take Imodium. Normal diarrhea, Imodium works.
Hello.
But it didn't cure it, you stopped the pain.
You fixed it.
And I have a cold. I don't have a cold anymore. And it's not addictive, it's all natural. And I'm like, stop lying. They still want people to catch cold. They do that.
Yeah.
But they said, well, this is for people who are traveling in airplanes.
What?
We're going to shoot this out the dump. No, you're going to shoot it out, you're going to give you the money to buy.
Exactly.
So they still get the money, but now they're not getting as much because everyone's afraid of the flu. They talk about the flu like it's some kind of rampaging monster.
Yes.
That's running through the world.
Uh-huh.
That, and then, you better get with me, you got the flu. Do you not know that if you do not be around anybody, you will not get sick as far as flu, cold, and stuff like that because it has to be carried on something. They say you got sick from mosquitoes and all this other stuff. That's just not true. They didn't stop lying. But all of a sudden, all these years in the universe, the mosquitoes have been alive.
Yes.
They decided to carry a new brand of flu.
Woo-hoo!
People get bit by mosquitoes every day. They don't run around with swine flu.
The special generated mosquitoes.
I'm like, this is just stupid. And they do have those special things. And that's the point I'm getting to. They're going to keep lying. They're going to keep lying, telling your kids, no, you got to take shot. I always wondered this. How come when they're in the house on the prairie day, even my room, I take shots?
They really didn't.
How come if your kid don't ever go to school, it's not a shot police come to the door?
Yes.
If they only say something when you want to get something for them, they say, well, okay, we can't do nothing for free, so if we are going to help you out of this situation, you must sacrifice your children to us.
Mm-hmm.
You must give us a, or your child to experiment on, because we want to get the special judge to see how he turns out.
What?
I mean, if people think for 5 minutes, seriously,
yeah.
If people think for 5 minutes, that there's no more smallpox, because we give vaccination. And the people over in Willow Land ain't got no vaccination. Willow Land.
Oh, sorry.
I never remember taking a smallpox vaccination.
Yes,
I
heard
it. If they stop that smallpox vaccination, I tell you what, go get your passport and say you're going to the deep dark heart of Africa.
Uh-huh.
You got to get a booster shot.
Yes.
I thought the disease ran.
Yes.
I thought there's no more smallpox in the world because America's people got the cure and they decided it wasn't going to show up no more.
Mm. Well,
they make it seem that way. They make it seem that if you get this, the disease is going to spike up and go somewhere else.
Mm-hmm.
Because you got a shot.
What?
But the shot, it tells you it's poison.
Mm-hmm.
That don't make sense. How many people believe that?
Man.
You got to get sick to get better.
That's it.
It builds up the white count, so if you put this in you so you can get better. No, you give us penicillin.
Yeah.
Which knocks out what you just put in us. So you give me this special drug called a flu vaccination. My body fights it. And it just, another flu company just decided they don't want to fight that. All the other flu companies just said, well, we're taking a break. We fight the Boom Judy flu. This is the Cucamonga flu.
Yes.
So don't call me until the Bajuda flu comes. You're just on your own. I know I'm a white blood cell and I'm supposed to fight off the disease, but I am specialized now. I'm a specialist. It's not mine.
Oh, that's good.
How is that possible?
I don't know.
You ask your doctor, he can't even explain it
to
you. How is it possible you give me a shot, my blood cells become specialized in killing the flu except the other kind of flu?
Yes.
So there are 100 different types of flu. Mine, but you gave me a kill 10 of them. The other 90, whatever how many more it is, he just decided to take the day off. But if I don't get the flu, it fights me. That don't make a lick of sense.
Not a lick.
They told me people walk around all day with a walking pneumonia. They still walking. People go through life, they don't even know they have the pneumonia. They have a walking pneumonia. It's very dangerous. They walk. They get better. They got better.
Yes.
Yeah, but it was very dangerous. So me sitting up in here and you sticking this stuff in me is not very dangerous. Oh, no. Y'all,
yes.
That's all I'm going to say about that.
Come on, y'all. Give y'all a hand. I do. When I put this on here, I knew Pastor was going to have quite a bit to say about that flu vaccine.
Yeah,
you know he's been preaching that for a long time, wasn't stay away from that flu vaccine. I want to make a comment, and we're going to have to, man, oh, I was just looking at time. Okay, one comment, and before we move on to the next slide, which is actually our last topic we're going to talk about with the sharing. When he's talked about experimenting on the kids, when he said that, my mind went back to a conversation that I had with my mom, where they came in, you know, what is that experiment they did on the men in Tuskegee, was it Tuskegee?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's what she was telling me the story, it reminded me of this. What they did was they came to their town and they was like, I don't know how many sets of twins. They got one of the twins and then they got a couple of other people from the different families. These are all from black families, and they took them someplace and they kept them for a while. And my mom, she's one of those twins that feels what the other twin feel. Anyway, they did all sorts of stuff on them and on the people that they took. And my mom was saying how her twin was so traumatized by it all, you know, and how terrible it was and how they drew blood and that's all she knew, that they drew blood and they gave her shots and they did these things. And I remember my mom was saying that they did her spinal tap on her. You know, that's when you stick a thing. Yeah, and so my mom feeling her twin, she bending over and like she can't walk straight. And her mom was like, what is wrong with your girl standing up straight? She's like, I can't do it. And she was a little girl, she couldn't stand up straight. But anyway, that connection with them is just amazing. But anyway, she found out that that's when they were doing the thing on her back. So they've been experimenting on kids, and the mentality of the parents back then or the people back then was, I guess they thought they had to because of the racism and all of the stuff like that was going on in that time, and also, you know, they were probably thinking that they wouldn't do any crazy, freaky stuff on the kids. Or maybe they did. They were just too scared. I don't know. But I want you to know that does go on. I mean, that happened back then, but it's still happening now. Okay, moving on to our next slide. I just had to put this in. I was just blown away by this thing right here, I'm telling you. The title of this says that this Pakistani man accuses the ambassador to U.S. of blasphemy. Okay, now the reason why I included this is, should we read the article? Yes. Okay, the overall thing is this particular ambassador, they had a picture of her, she said in a talk show back in 2010 that she thought the Pakistani law regarding blasphemy needed to be looked at, mm-hmm. reviewed. What did you say, Pastor? Mm-hmm. Yeah, let's go around the room and read it, because I think we'll get a better idea of how foolish it is. Oh, Pastor, yeah, go ahead, read, Pastor. Pastor, if you would start out.
Pakistani man accuses ambassador to U.S. of blasphemy. Mujani Vasavis rulers, Pakistani police register to the accusation from a businessman on Thursday that the country ambassador to the United States had committed blasphemy, a crime of carrying death penalty in connection with the 2010 TV's talk show. The accusation against Ambassador Sherry Renham is the latest in a string of controversial blasphemy cases in Pakistan. Elijah Muslim nation name translates as Lord of Pure.
Hold on. Okay, a couple things I wanted to point out in here. Okay, now this, I thought it was just, anyway. The name of this, the Pakistan, the name that it says translates to the land of the pure. Okay? Stick that. Pen. Also, in the pen in your head, this is a Muslim nation, and the different signs or things that we've been seeing around to say, to try to get people to convert to Muslim. I saw a sign that says Muhammad, Jesus, Moses, they said a few names. All the same or something like that, said preaching the same message, you know, different things like that. Okay, just have it in your mind. And then I put this next section that Pastor's going to read in bold, because this is just ridiculous. Go ahead, Pastor.
According to Pakistan blasphemy laws, anyone found to have uttered words derogatory to the Prophet Muhammad can be put to death. Those who are accused are sometimes lynched by mobs even before they reach court. Rehan has already faced death penalty, death threats from the militants after calling for reforms to the country's anti-blasphemy law. According to court documents, two politicians who suggest reforming the law were assassinated.
Okay, hold on. Just look at this. Okay, if anyone found to have other words derogatory to the Prophet Muhammad. Now, this lady says, she's saying that the countries, and the next thing it says, she called for the country's anti-blasphemy law that it needs to be reformed. Now, also, two other politicians that had said the same thing
They were assassinated just for saying that. Y'all hear that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I just want you to see that. Okay, let me read the next two, Pastor. No, read it, Pastor. Yes.
The case against Reedman was brought by businessman Mohammed Fahim Gill.
Yes.
Let's not forget the Gill.
Yes.
He's 31.
Yes.
Who said, here's my mic on, there it is, who said that the comments Reedman made about the law on the Pakistan talk show in 2010 were blasphemous.
Yeah.
I've been practicing.
Yes.
I've been trying to get this case registered to the last 3 years, ever since I saw that TV show. YouTube Reuters, who was responsible for the reasons that I've even gone to the highest court. I'm glad. What's that word, Ellen? Now, the action you find be taken. You're supposed to say utilities every 7. Action will be found. Be taken now.
Yes.
So this man, for 3 years,
I'm gonna come back.
Okay. This, for 3 years, he's been fussing and taking this case, trying to get this lady accused of blasphemy. For 3 years, for that making a comment. Go ahead, Pastor.
Well, you know, I just happened to be watching TV.
He was watching.
And I was practicing on my South African accent.
Ooh.
Because they told me all of the sugar bears were gonna go.
Yes.
And my wife called me Honey Girl, so I know I will be on the first round of the sugar bears must go. Now, in order to be a sugar bear, you must know what's going on. I was watching the TV show, and the TV show was called Jack Vanner Presents.
Uh-huh.
And on Jack Vanner Presents, he had a letter with over 300 Christian ministers had signed that said that the God of Islam and the God of the Bible are the same God. And one of the persons that's headlining the scripture is Mr. The life-driven, purpose-driven life, Mr. Purpose-driven life man himself, yes, RJ, the purpose-driven life man himself, senior must be trying to say something to me.
Yes.
Rick Warren, thank you, senior. Yeah, he watched it with me. Senior Junior watched me in his dreams.
Yes.
No, as he was trying to help me out, Mr. Rick Warren not only states that the God of the Bible is the God of the Islam and that Christianity and Islam is really the same thing, and he also has opened 3 of them. Count 1, 2, 3.
Gentlemen.
You missed my
answer. Yes, he did.
I will do it again. 1, 2, 3.
Yes!
3 schools over in Islamic countries to teach that Christianity and Islam is the same religion. Now, not only that, I'm a stand up for this. The man in whom he is in partnership with, who is coming out of his pocket with all the money to make this possible, has publicly stated that Islam and Christianity is basically the same religion, and that Jesus will return, but he will not return as the so-called Messiah. He will return as the prophet. And as the prophet, it will be his job to kill, and I quote, to kill, not only kill, but to cut off the heads of everyone who believe he died on the cross. He will then straighten out that he never died on the cross. And he will go around preaching then that there is no son of the most living God. Now, what am I like to believe in? I'm saying that
okay.
Yes. If I was making a new
ace,
I'm going to say, it was 3. Now, I was saying to those who are listening, the millions.
Millions.
And millions.
And millions.
That he not only stated that this so-called Jesus will come back and not only crucify those who said he died on the cross. And not only would he do that, he would publicly state that there is no son, only begotten son of God, that there is no other one beside Allah. And that he would then go and lead a rebellion against the so-called children of God that came from the Lord of Abraham, better known as the Israelites.
Are you kidding me?
So in their religion, everyone can join except the Jews. And so then this certain Messiah, he will lead, not the Messiah, I'm sorry, this certain so-called Jesus will lead an army against the Israeli, the Jews, to take by Jerusalem as the capital of Israel. Well, they're calling it Chrislam. And then they're saying that there is no God but Allah. That is the document where that is who Britain has joined up with to spread the new gospel that they are now preaching called, and they're calling it the new gospel, they call it the Chrislam. But you would think, and I quote, are you still listening or am I bored? Okay, you would think that someone who supposedly be, you see how I'm making the diamond sign and I cut it out? They're supposedly so smart and so wise as Mr. Rick Warren, and supposed to be a biblical scholar. He must be. He's a multi-billionaire who wrote a book that didn't even quote the Bible, but made up verses as he went along. So he must be a very smart man. You would think he would know about the verse in the Bible that says, and ironically, I thought it was amazing that Paul, what? It was spoken by Paul. He said, I could be mistaken. He said, if anyone come and preach to you another gospel,
yeah,
other than the gospel that I have spoken, let him be accursed.
Yes.
You know, that is exactly what they call it, another gospel. So, we already know that there is scoffers in the land, and there's a good example of a hypocrite.
Yes.
And I wanted to say that because this article goes right along with how the world is turning, because they will let them do that. Now, not only that, but the United States have freed Islam countries from the oppressors. The oppressors were another Islam group.
Mm-hmm.
But all of them go by Sharia. You know, all the men went over to Iraq. They did not die to defend truth, justice, and the American dream. No, they died and they gave the country right back to Iraq. And Iraq leaders were secretly being controlled by the Iranians, according to certain reports.
Mm-hmm.
And the United States knew this, and then they changed office. And then the first thing they did was try to get the people to leave there to go to another Islamic-controlled country to get another Islamic group in charge. So you have people sending their sons and daughters over to die to further the cause of Islam. Now, and this would be my final remark on this subject maybe. Now, after all of that is said and done, the people still would not say anything. Your president, the name he plays, plays the Quran. He held up the Quran and said, this is a holy scripture.
Okay.
It was all in the news and everyone went crazy. He called the Quran the holy scriptures. So he put it on the same stamp as what we call our holy, or our standard for our consecrated scriptures, the Bible. And now, I will step back because they confused Paul with that, and they said Paul messed up. But when you see what Paul wrote, it's truth in what Paul wrote. But they are trying to judge Paul's lifestyle and say the Bible is no good because of what Paul did. And we have no idea what Paul did. We have no idea what James and John did. What they do is they speculate and add on. I seen the preacher the other day, yesterday, if you are interested in how this stuff spread, there's a preacher yesterday who condemned and preached the truth and said, yeah, yo, you need to preach the cross, You know, leave Paul alone. He didn't even preach the cross, but then he got up and then he preached tradition of Jewish tradition, saying that Moses was this and Moses was that, and that Pharaoh looked at Moses and blessed him, and they prophesied over Moses and said that he was going to be the one to overthrow Pharaoh, and Pharaoh got off his throne and went there and touched him and said, oh, he's full of strife. This is the tradition. And I never heard of that before in my life. He preached, the majority of his message was preached on that. And I'm not saying any name, but I think his name was Jimmy Swaggart. And I watched it full of interest because it was amazing how you can say one man is wrong because of his lifestyle, and you are right when you are preaching a lie. You preach the truth, but don't lie, that is courage.
Woo!
That's a lot of time.
Boy.
Y'all give y'all a hand for what I'm telling you. That was messy. That boy, Chris Long, that's a bunch of foolishness.
You got my accent? I'm working hard on
it. I don't know about that accent. At this last slide, I wanna get it in because there's something very important. Anybody got anything to say?
Yeah, it's time. Go ahead.
I don't have anything to add, but we're here. We're not saying nothing.
Okay.
We're here. We're listening.
Okay. All right, here we go. It says, Gil went to the Supreme Court with his complaint after police refused to register it. So he went to police, and the police said, you're crazy. And he went to the Supreme Court. The court ordered police in the central Pakistani city of Multan to investigate. Blasphemy accusations are on the rise, according to a report released by the Islamaban-based think tank. Yes. Center of Security Studies. At least 52 people accused of blasphemy have been killed since 1990. The charge is difficult to defend since blasphemy is not defined, and courts often hesitate to hear the evidence, fearful that reproducing it will also be blasphemy. Did y'all understand that? They scared to even hear it because they said if they hear the case, then that could be blasphemy. And then they don't want to support it. And then it says recent cases included a teacher who made a mistake setting homework, a man who threw away a business card belonging to a man named Muhammad, and a Pakistani Christian girl, Risha Masi, who was accused of burning pages of Muslim holy texts last year. The teenager was cleared by a court after it emerged that she may have been framed by a cleric trying to evict Christians from his area. She and her family are now in hiding. So you see, this is what I want you to see, that anybody could just accuse. This is what it did. This sounded like this person just accused this girl of blasphemy and made up these things. And if you read in the article that for the most part, they don't make it to court. People kill them before they even get to the court. And his last thing says, Rehman, a prominent member of the ruling Pakistani People's Party, was appointed as ambassador of the United States in November 2011. So that's just crazy. So apparently she made this statement in 2010, and she was made the ambassador in 2011, and this man has been trying since 2010 to get somebody to kill her for blasphemy. Yeah. Foolishness? Yep, it sure is. Alrighty then. It's been a day of sharing, a long day of sharing. Oh, Pastor, I'm sorry.
My pastor has his hand up to say something.
I'm just going to say it right quick. They did the same thing in witchcraft. They started accusing people of being witchcraft. And they would kill them without having a fair trial. I just want to throw that out there. Within religion, it normally starts out that way. That the people in the past religion are people that are in a position to threaten the new religion or the old religion, whatever it may be, will be falsely accused and made
open shame. That's what's one of the things that Yeshua did here to Yeshua, and that's why they wanted him crucified, to be put in open shame. That's why they made him naked, and they wanted him to feel ashamed for the things he said and show the people that his shameful acts had brought by shame. But we all know that in the end, it brought by glory.
Yes.
So, I mean, that's why they do these things. They may happen to you. They may threaten you. I mean, I've had stuff happen to me because of what I believe. I know for a fact that the windows was bust down in my car because we had one in the neighborhood fast knock truck.
Oh, yes.
And the only car that was there was our car. It had a little thing on the back, set on the club, all the stickers in. And the next morning, I woke up and the windows was broke. You have to be very, like you should say, you have to be cautious and civil. In other words, you got to really circumspect before you do things. And I just wanted to say that real quick. It's not the fact that they're blaming each other. They do that all the time.
Mm-hmm.
It's the fact that this world is corrupt.
Yeah.
And really, court is just a mimic of what Yah set up that he called justice.
Mm-hmm.
So do it.
Amen.
Amen. Good stuff. Come on, give y'all a hand for this. And for our day of sharing. Amen. Very good. Very good stuff. I want to encourage you to continue to send me what your finds, and we're going to fine tune this. It's going to flow a little bit better the more we do it, and the more we get things in order. Amen. But I thought it was some very interesting stuff that was shared on today. Excellent discussion, a lot for us to take home. Amen.
Amen.
Next week we're going to hopefully wrap up Kwanzaa. Well, you know, I keep saying hopefully, but because the last time we only made it through one slide. We'll get into some very interesting parts of it that I think is going to be a lot of lively discussion connected with it. So please just take some time and skim over the Kwanzaa thing so you can make yourself familiar with it before our next class.
What are we doing now, please?
10-15 minute break. Go to zone.
Okay. And right now,
Let me make the announcement. What we're going to do right now, so you'll understand, is what has on today. I got something I want to say. We're going to have a slight zone. If you want to participate, I guarantee you'll get some out of it. That's why I want to take about 10-15 minute break so you can refresh yourself. This went way longer than I thought it would go. We got a little carried away, and it's way over. It's a big time. So I want you to refresh your mind. And so you can receive, and zone is not going to be that long. So we can receive this little brief thing and have fun with it. And be energized. I know it's been a long day for you, but I ain't making no excuse. We got to do what we got to do.
Okay.
So those of you who want to participate and be here and have fun, I thank you in advance, and I'll see you at the about 15-minute break. I want to shoot 4 or 5:30 so everyone can be refreshed. If that's too long, it's too long. I called it early, but I mean, the people here, you know, and I don't know how the people at home, you know, I know it may be real hard for the people at home because you're home, you know, jumping in bed. So it's up to you. I can't make nobody do anything.
Yes. Amen.
All right, we got our instructions. Come on, give the Father a hand clap praise for another episode of Covenant, Vow, and Contract. Oh, man, you're dismissed for your break.
Jim, before you take off, help Elder's name move that right down there. I think Jim could do that. Yeah, I appreciate it. The music, and then we'll bring this up there. And I keep on listening. Mm-hmm.